爱求我，你说你那不一样，就是你一生我会带你去救。That's all。
Today we have a couple of intentions. We pray for the intention of Teresa, Ellis, Bum, Willette, Hardesty, Jackson, and Wright families. We also pray for Dr. Tina as she continues to become a healthier and a holier person in her life.We also remember those who just lost their loved ones and their family. For those people who suffer with COVID right now and Delta right now. And those people who suffer with natural disasters this day. So let us put all together and ask our Mother Mary to help us and intercede for us. Immaculate Mary, your praises we sing, who reigns now with Christ, our Redeemer and King. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria, Ave, Ave Maria.Most Holy and Immaculate Virgin and our Mother Mary, you are our perpetual help, our refuge, and our hope. We come to you today. We thank God for all the graces received through your intercession. Mother of perpetual help, we promise to love you always and to do all we can to lead others to you. Mother of perpetual help, confident of your powerful influence with God, obtain for us these graces.Strength to overcome temptation, a perfect love for Jesus Christ, and a holy death, so that we will live with you and your Son for all eternity. Let us pray to be open to God's word. Mother of perpetual help, you continually sow the meaning of God's words and actions in your life, if you will listen to our God. May your Holy Spirit enlighten our understanding.And give us the courage to put his words into practice to our daily lives. Let us kneel to pray as a community of faith. Mary, all generations have called you blessed, and the Almighty has done great things for you. Mother of perpetual help, we call upon your most powerful name. Your very name inspires confidence and hope. May it always be on our lips.Especially in time of temptation and at the hour of our death. Blessed Lady, help us whenever we call on you. Let us not be content with merely pronouncing your name. May our daily lives proclaim that you are our mother and our perpetual help. Let us pray for our temple ones. Mother of perpetual help, with the greatest confidence we kneel before you.We implore your help in the problems of our daily lives. Trial and sorrows often depress us. Misfortunes and privation bring misery into our lives. Everywhere we meet the cross, comforter of the afflicted, beg your Son Jesus to strengthen us as we bear our burdens and to free us from our sufferings. Or if it be the will of God that we shall suffer still longer,Help us endure all with love and patience. May we follow the example of your Son, and through him, with him, and in him, commend ourselves to the care of our Heavenly Father. Let us stand now to present our petitions and our thanks. Lord Jesus Christ, at the word from Mary, your mother, You changed water into wine of Cana of Galilee. Listen now to the people of God gathered here to honor our perpetual, Mother Perpetual Help. Grant our petitions and accept our sincere thanks. Grant wisdom and guidance to our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Bishop Michael Gerard, our priests, redemptive missionaries, and all the leaders of our nation, state, and community.
Hear us, Lord, through Mary, our Mother.
Grant peace and unity throughout the world, especially in our homes and families.
Hear us, Lord, through Mary, our Mother.
Grant that young people respond generously to the call of the Holy Spirit in deepening their faith and choosing their vocation in life.
Hear us, Lord, through Mary, our Mother.
Grant us continued health of mind and body, and help the sick, especially those we just mentioned, to regain their health according to your holy will.
Hear us, Lord, to Mary our Mother.
Grant eternal rest to all our deceased, especially those who just passed away for Travis Wright, and to the souls of all the faithful departed. Let us pause now to silently present our own petitions to our Mother of Perpetual Help. Lord, accept our thanks for the new life of grace you gave us.
We thank you, Lord, through Mary our Mother.
Accept our thanks for all the graces received through your sacramental life of the Church.
We thank you, Lord, through Mary our Mother.
Accept our thanks for the spiritual and material blessings we have received. Let us pause now to suddenly thank our Mother Perpetual Help for our own favor received. Please kneel as we pray for the sick. Lord, look upon your servants laboring under bodily weakness. Cherish and revive the souls which you have created so that purified by their sufferings, they may soon find themselves healed by your mercy. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us now reach out our right hand and remember those who ask us to pray for them or for ourselves. May the Lord Jesus Christ be with you, that he may defend you, within you, that he may sustain you, before you, that he may lead you, behind you, that he may protect you, above you, that he might bless you, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us renew our confidence in Mary as a perpetual help. Mother of perpetual help, you have been blessed and favored by God. You became not only the mother of Redeemer, but the mother of Redeemer as well. We come to you today as your loving children. Watch over us and take care of us. As you held the child Jesus in your loving arms, so take us in your arms. Be a mother ready at every moment to help us. For God, who is mighty, has done great things for you, and his mercy is from age to age on those who love him. Our greatest fear is that in time of temptation, we may fail to call out to you and become lost children. Intercede for us, dear mother, in obtaining pardon for our sins, love for Jesus, final perseverance, and the grace always to call upon you, Mother of Perpetual Help. Let us stand now and unite with the Christians of all ages and also our students today. They start doing the novena every Tuesday. And so, in praising Mary and in committing ourselves to her powerful protection. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, who gave us your Mother Mary, whose image we venerate as a mother ready at every moment to help us, grant, we beg you, that we who call on her help may always enjoy the fruit of your redemption. This we ask to you, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
In heaven the blessed your glory proclaim. On earth we your children invoke your fair name. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave Maria. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Bob.
Today, the church celebrates St. Lawrence, deacon and martyr. He's a patron saint of barbecue. Now, that's weird, right? But he died as a deacon, as a martyr. So, the finance Council of Emperor of Rome. How you say that? Tried to punish him because of his faith, of his conviction. So one day they came over and say, show me the richness of your parish, of your church. And so he brought all the poor, the sick, the elderly, the crippled. And he said, this is the richness of my church. I feel like we have the same situation here. So we have a lot of poor families in this family, in this church. That is the richness of our parish, of our church today. Let us embrace them, pray for them, and accompany them so that they continue to meet. We meet them in heaven. As one day we get together. So today, let us, with the church, celebrate a beautiful feast, St. Lawrence, and ask God to give us that strong faith, endurance, perseverance, so that we meet together with Christ in heaven. Lord Jesus, you come to save us from our sins. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you come to sacrifice for us, giving us your body and blood. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come to teach us how to love you and one another to the saints. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Oh, today we have glory in glory to God because of this beautiful saint. So let us say together, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to his people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayers. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
I also like to remember my youth group in Vietnam, where I came from years ago. There's patron saint today, St. Lawrence. So pray for them, especially the Vietnamese people who struggle a lot with the COVID right now. Let us pray. O God, giver of that order of love for you, by which St. Lawrence was outstandingly faithful in service and glorious in martyrdom, grant that we may love what he loved and put into practice what he taught. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated to let's listen to the word of God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul, second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Each must do as already determined, without sadness or compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. Moreover, God is able to make every grace abundant for you, so that in all things, always having all you need, as you may have an abundance for every good work. As it is written, he scatters abroad, he gives to the poor, his righteousness endures forever. The one who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will supply and multiply your seed and increase the harvest of your righteousness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commands. His prosperity shall be mighty upon the earth. The upright generation shall be blessed. Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need. Well for the man who is gracious and lends, who conducts his affairs with justice. He shall never be moved. The just one shall be in everlasting remembrance. Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need. An evil report he shall not fear. His heart is firm, trusting in the Lord. His heart is steadfast. He shall not fear till he looks down upon his foes. Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need. Lavishly he gives to the poor. His generosity shall endure forever. His horn shall be exalted in glory. Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia,
whoever,
alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life, says the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Whoever loves his life loses it, and whoever hates his life in this world will preserve it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me. And where I am, there also will my servant be. The Father will honor whoever serves me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When we celebrate the feast like this feast, St. Lawrence, deacon and martyr, and his act of love, an act of faith, was so vivid. How could you do that? Imagine that you were on a grill. Now, this is the legend, this is a story. He was like on the grill, like barbecue grill. And they grilled him one side and he said, "It's done already. You can flip it now. You can turn me over." And you believe that? You want medium rare, or you want rare, or you want done? I'm sure you want it well done. Go for it. To that moment of his life, he's still not joking around, has a sense of humor, a sense of joy, a sense of confidence. And that's what we're talking about. We're talking about not just die halfway, we die all the way. We're not just giving a little bit of here and there, but we give everything. And the most important thing that we give is we give ourselves completely. The late Cardinal Francis Xavier Wiman Thuan said, you give everything away, including your bank account, including your house, your wife, your husband, your loved one. You can give everything away, but yourself, you're not given anything. That's the ultimate love that God desires from us. God wants us nothing, no sacrifices, but mercy, trust, completely ourselves. The problem here is when we completely given ourselves, we don't give anything. We even gain. Think about that grain die underground. In the eyes, temporary, naked eyes, yes, that seed dies. But in a very short moment, that seed blooming with thousand and thousand more grains. Food, beauty, and life again. And so if we truly die to ourselves, giving ourselves away, my brothers and sisters, we doesn't lose anything, but even gain. That's why sometimes I say, no pain, but all gains. Our society said, no pain, no gain. But if we truly believe in God and goes God's way, no pain, but all gains. How many times we sacrifice our lives for others? And even in our lifetime, we could experience the fruit of it. What a blessing, right? A lot of times we don't see the fruits, like our own children. They don't appreciate us enough until we die. But don't be afraid to give. Keep giving until we can't give anymore. Sometimes I'm joking and reminding my friends, we need to practice dying every day so that when we truly die, we die completely. Every time I go to bed at night, I put my sheet over my body, close my eyes. It's just like I'm sitting in a funeral home, then they put a seat over my body. Now it's scary, but we need to try it. Try it every day. Sometimes God practices us, help us to practice dying by taking a cell phone away, by taking the car key away, by taking one of our loved ones away, by taking our organs away, our limbs away, our senses away, our sight away, so that eventually we submit ourselves to the will of God completely. So let us be generous and be courageous. Believe that God will take care of us. Believe that our sacrifices not going in vain, but will produce not 50, not 60, but even 100-fold. So may God bless us today as we celebrate the feast of one of our martyrs, so that we, given to our neighbors here, the richness of God right here in our 70805, let us be joyful and hopeful that God is with us. And God continues to remind us the beauty and the goodness of God in our lives. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness we have received this bread to offer you. Food of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have received this wine to offer you. Food of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us the spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, our loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name. For our good of all of his holy church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, the offerings we joyfully make on the feast day of St. Lawrence, and grant that they become a help to our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift it up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy, you give honor to their faith. To their endurance, you grant firm resolve. And in their struggle, the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration. And we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim, Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly to his passion, he took bread and gave him thanks, broke it, and gave it to disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to disciples saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be guided into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Michael Gerard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, especially those we mentioned in this Mass.
who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with Blessed Apostles, St. Lawrence, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Let us stand now in gratitude and joy with all the saints and with Mary that we celebrate Assumption this Sunday. She's in heaven, also on earth. Continue to pray for us and intercede for us. So with joy, let us now pray the prayer Jesus himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we might be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with each other a sigh of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who call to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. The body of Christ. May God be with you, bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Thank you very much.
Say amen.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Amen. The body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
communion and to fawn. Whoever serves me must follow me. And where I am, there also will my servants be, says the Lord. Let us pray. Nourished by these sacred gifts, we humbly implore you, O Lord, that the homage of dutiful service which we render on the feast of St. Lawrence may bring us an increase of your saving grace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Today at 11 o'clock, we serve food for hungry. So if you have time, please stop by. If you know any families, we have a lot of flyers. If you have time, I don't have time to go around and pass it out to our neighbors, but just keep that in mind. If you know any neighbors that you, even you drive by here or you walk by and you say, hey, we have food over here, if you looking for something, you know, just to keep them in your heart, in your agenda, and keep praying for them. Sometimes I see a lot of houses with long, tall grass, and it's poor houses. Maybe they need some help there. So don't be afraid to stop by. They're very nice people. All right, so keep them in your mind, in your journey, and invite them if they need food, Tuesday and Thursdays, 11 to 1. So what a beautiful service from our church here. So we thank God for all this, and thank you. Have a wonderful day. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace and joy.
Thanks be to God.